And we welcome you to the south side of Chicago and Guaranteed Rate Field. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Cleveland Guardians going up against the Chicago White Sox. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about set to go. Showing the slab in today's game, Mike Clevinger.
Well, this guy has the ability to command the game. He's got to limit damage, make his pitches, and avoid that big inning. If he can work around that, he can give a quality start, hand this off to the bullpen later on, and put his team in a position to win the game.
Here's Andrés Giménez. And he deals. Hit weakly on the ground towards second. One out in the top of the first. Here's the Guardians lineup now. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
Well, we know guys are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a guy who's got decent pop.
Steven Kwan stands in here, leaves that one off the inside. And the righty deals. And a seed into center. That's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Everything came together for him. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Here's Jose Ramirez. He has, as they like to say, light tower power. Not a big guy, but a big swing. And thunder in that bat. You know, Singy, Jose Ramirez signed that big extension, a five-year, $124 million contract before the 2022 season. But right before that happened, the Guardians came this close to trading him. Next pitch, not close, up high. And that one just missed off the outside edge.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
In there at the knees for a strike. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
That is cool. The catcher, Mike.
First and second, one out. Here's Mike Zunino. And strike one to the catcher.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
One out. Runners at first and second. That one hammered, but pulled foul. Oh, and two now. Next offering misses down and away. Here comes a pitch. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, that was a tough slider right there. He couldn't get a piece of it just to try to keep the at-bat alive. And hitters will tell you that slider, when a guy's able to really tunnel the pitch where it looks like a fastball and then late, has really good bite, so tough to lay off of because you've made the decision you don't want to get beat by a fastball, and then you swing and you miss. You go back to the dugout shaking your head.
Josh Naylor up to bat next, lays off for a ball. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Bounced out to short. Third out. Guardians nothing. White Sox coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here on the south side. And today's starter, Logan Allen.
He really needs to be able to throw all three of his pitches for strikes in this one. Otherwise, these hitters are going to start sitting on pitches. You know, you've got to try to get the swing and miss with the curveball. You've got to move your pitches around. Don't get too comfortable on one side of the plate unless they're showing that they just can't hit that spot.
Here's Tim Anderson. Line drive. Takes it in for the out. Time to check out the lineup for the White Sox. Their opponent on the mound today does run into some trouble finding the strike zone at times. So, Singy, I got to figure part of the plan, be patient, be selective today.
Yeah, you know, coming in, regardless of, you know, what that first inning's going to look like, you know his history. You don't want to help him out. You've got to be patient and make sure that when you attack, that it's a pitch that you can do some damage with. Otherwise, just build up some traffic on the base pass, push across some easy runs, and perhaps get into some of those gap arms in the bullpen.
Luis Robert, the next to hit, takes ball one. Next pitch is downstairs. Kicks and fires. And there's a ball. Here's a 3-0. And there's ball four.
Bell just came apart right there. Four pitch walk. And guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
Benintendi to the plate. Now snap throw to first. Robert dives back in. Benintendi, the former first round pick, Golden Spikes Award winner. Lead runner touches second, headed for third. And they'll have runners at the corners after a one-out single.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I can see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
And first offering is fouled off. Way out front for strike two.
Big pitch right here. He's going to try to make a pitch that's going to produce a strikeout or a ground ball double play.
Next offering is down low, and that is ball one. And the 1-2 misses to even the count.
They tried to get him to go, chase the pitch down and away, but he wouldn't bite.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. And another ball.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
One out, base is loaded. Here is Moncada. That misses, and it's 1-0.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boog.
Base is loaded. One away. That one is absolutely belted. One runs in, and that one is off the wall. The relay throw, safe at the plate. 3-0.
Well, that breaks the tie in a big way, clearing the bases. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
Andrew Vaughn now. First pitch, and he just misses. Foul ball. And here it comes.
2-1.
Well, Boog, early on in this one, having a hard time getting settled in. He's not showing control to throw strikes, and let alone to throw it where he wants in the strike zone. This could be a tough one for him.
Come on, no yard here.
That one out to right. He makes the grab, and there's two down.
Batting seven, the catcher, Yasmani.
Yasmani Grandal up to hit.
Come on, get that, Jimmy.
Misses outside, 1-0. There's a strike. Two outs and one in scoring position.
Nice easy stroke. Let's go.
Next pitch misses. 2-1. Two outs. Misses outside, and that's ball three. Ripped to short. Rosario tosses the first. That takes care of Grandal, and that ends the inning. But three runs come across in the inning, all on this three-run double. It's now 3-0. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. New inning getting started. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Oscar Gonzalez. Clevinger back to work.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Out towards right center. That's well struck. That's back. And it's off the wall. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
He was all over that one. Anytime you smoke a ball off the wall, you kind of think about what it could have been, but obviously you have to be happy with that result.
Here's Josh Bell. Swing and a miss. That's strike one. Runner at second. Nobody out. Next offering is in for a strike.
James Kingsley working the plate. Kingsley's pretty well respected around the league.
Yeah, when you talk to players, I think consistently he is one of the guys you hear compliments about. Players appreciate the job he does back there.
Yeah, and that's kind of all you can ask for, really, just a fair chance to go out and have success.
Swing and a miss. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Good late cut for the strikeout there. That thing really got in on him. And, you know, the cutter isn't really a huge swing and miss pitch most of the time because it's not really meant to move a whole lot. You're just trying to miss the big part of the barrel and maybe get some weak contact. But that one right there did a whole lot more than that. That was a really good pitch.
The 1-0.
Nope, that's inside.
One out and a runner at second. Jack swing, went around, and that is strike one. Outside.
One strike.
To the right side. And he takes it himself for the out.
Batting up. The center fielder, number seven, Miles.
Yeah, the batter now, Miles Straw.
Boog, this guy's just a tremendously talented center fielder. Gold glove caliber type out there. Offensively, he can do some things, but you know, also has some streakiness as well. I think the key, just trying to find a way for him to be consistent day in and day out. You know, he saves runs in the outfield, so that's going to buy him more time to work things out at the dish.
And there's the strike.
Now, there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Pitch. That one just misses.
It's a good take.
Next pitch is outside.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
This one smoked out to left. And Benintendi able to make the grab. One left for the Guardians. They trail it here 3-0. Back at Guaranteed Rate Field. And now the right fielder, number 79. The pitch. And ball one to the right fielder. Singy, he wasn't real sharp in the first, got hit around, but really more so, didn't throw a ton of strikes.
Well, he's just got to find a way to settle down. He was clearly fighting himself out there, not really finding the strike zone, walking batters. So we'll see if he can get back on track and fill up the zone a little bit more.
Check swing didn't go. And that's ball two.
Almost got him to commit, but he held back.
Into center and a base hit.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Here's Elvis Andrus.
Elvis,
and that one pulled foul. Nobody out, runner at first. That one hammered center field. Straw ranging back. Back some more. And that one's gone. That fires up the home crowd, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 5-0.
Gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Tim Anderson, the next to hit. He's 0 for 1. That one off the bad part of the bat, just a lazy fly ball. Gonzalez grabs it on the run.
Up next to Chicago, the center field.
Luis Robert now. He walked and came around to score his first time up. And a good eye there.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Next offering is in for a strike. They say it went.
One ball, two strikes.
And a 1-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. One down, base is empty. Robert checks his swing. Now it appeal to first. And yes, he did. That's a swing, according to Gary Simmons.
The left fielder, number
Andrew Benintendi up to the plate. One for one with a single and a run scored so far. The Red Sox made Andrew Benintendi the 7th overall pick in 2015. And remember, he won the Golden Spikes Award for the top college player that year at the University of Arkansas. He had two guys in his conference that were drafted ahead of him. Alex Bregman, who went 2nd overall from LSU. Dansby Swanson, who went 1st overall out of Vanderbilt. The wind of the pitch. On a line out towards center. Straw brings it in for the 3rd out. But 2 come across to score in the inning courtesy of this 2-run homer. And the lead is now 5-0. You're dialed into the show. Welcome back onto the 3rd inning. And stepping in is the speedy Andrés Giménez. Clevinger back to work.
And he almost won one more award in 2017 when he finished runner-up to Aaron Judge for Rookie of the Year. The next season, he won the World Series with the Red Sox.
Rocketed out towards right center. And there's a hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
So a man aboard, digging in, Stephen Kwan. Clevinger with a pickoff throw, and he's back in safely. Lifted in the air, right center field. Robert moves under it, and he makes the catch. One down.
Now batting, third base, Jose Ramirez.
Man at first. Jose Ramirez digs in for the Guardians.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
The 1-1.
That's a ball.
That one pulled foul. Clevenger with a pickoff throw, and he's back in on a dive. Another move to first, and he's back in that time as well. And there he goes. Hit hard, base hit. Jimenez around second, on his way to third. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
Now here is Mike Zunino. That's in for a strike.
0-1.
Next offering is fouled back. Runners are at the corners, one away. That one not close. It's a ball and two strikes. And down on strikes he goes. That's out number two.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
Naylor at the plate for the second time as he takes ball one. Grounded out his first time. Corners are occupied with two down. And that one fouled off.
A little early on that fastball. I'm sure the pitcher taking a note. Look for an off-speed pitch on this next one.
Ball and a strike. They say it went.
One ball, two strikes.
Runs it up to 96 to record the punch out.
A couple of strikeouts with runners on. Sometimes you got to really bear down, and he did just that. Nice job of getting out of the jam and out of the inning.
As we go to the last of the third. So now it's the White Sox DH, Eloy Jimenez. And a pitch. Jimenez measures 6'4", batting in the cleanup spot. And though usually in left field, today he's the designated hitter. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Ramirez settles under it. Puts the squeeze on that one. And there's one away. Now here is Yoan Moncada. Doubled his first time up.
Some guys don't like not being able to play defense because it helps him to stay in the rhythm. So for him to be the DH, we'll see if he gets a routine together.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. That's off the mark, and now 2-0.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
There's a strike.
As a hitter, you got to learn something from that pitch. He clearly wasn't timed up on the fastball. In a 2-0 count, you have to be ready to do damage.
Fouls one off, 2-2. In the air, right field. Gonzalez moves under this one and puts the squeeze on that one. Two down.
The first baseman, number 25, Andrew
Vaughn, steps to the plate for the White Sox. Vaughn, 24 years old, a former first-round pick back in 2019. Here's a strike. And it's fouled away. The 0-2. Rolled over to third. Ramirez. Zips it across. Three up, three down, inning over. Nothing doing for the White Sox, but they hold a 5-0 lead. Back here at the ballpark, out of the fourth, and now here's a speed threat, outfielder Oscar Gonzalez. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite-level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. Pitch misses there, ball one.
But this guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths. Everything came together perfectly for him right there. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
Clips the corner, strike one. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a bouncer. In time to Vaughn. That's the first out in the top of the fourth.
The bat, number one. Shortstop.
And now it's Ahmed Rosario. 0 for 1 so far. And there's the strike.
All one's the count.
Let's go, defense!
That's in there.
Well, he's gotten ahead with two pitches down in the zone. He has plenty of options right here. He can go up, he can go away, he can add velocity, he can subtract.
Going two now. And he hits a ground ball right side. Fires over to first. Two away.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Here's the center fielder, Miles Straw. He's 0 for 1. In there for strike one. Runner at third, two away. And the right-hander deals. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Guardians lead one. It's 5-0. And welcome back. John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Yasmani Grandal. The wind and the pitch. Ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Fires to first. That takes care of Grandal.
Now back, the right fielder, Oscar.
So up next for Chicago, number 79. Singled and scored his first time. Pitch misses there, and that's ball one. And now the lefty. Swinging a foul straight back. Here's a 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
That's a little bit low. Struck him out looking with the off-speed stuff.
This guy will throw any pitch in any count. 3-2, he goes off speed, gets the out.
Elvis Andrus steps to the plate for the White Sox. He's 1-for-1 with a 2-run homer his first time up. And takes low for ball one. And a strike in there. And a pitch. And a big swing and a miss.
He's been able to go inside as well as outside, effectively working both sides of the plate in this at bat.
Two down, nobody on. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Just misses with that one.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Next offering upstairs.
He wanted that fastball high and tight, looking for a strikeout, just didn't locate it very well.
And a ground ball to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. 1-2-3 go the White Sox as they are unable to add to their 5-0 lead. Here on the south side, and now it's going to be Andrés Giménez. The pitch. There's a strike.
You know, these Guardians looking to string together better at bats when they have runners on, but it just hasn't happened for them yet. They've had their chances with runners in scoring position, but nobody's been able to deliver a big hit in those situations.
Left-hand hitter waits.
Ball.
And a count 1-2. Up the middle. Now the throw to first on the run. One away here in the fifth.
I love how guys at this level are able to slow the game down, whether it's in the batter's box or on defense. And right there, that was a good job of knowing just how much time he had. We talk about that internal clock. He was able to gather himself, get a good grip, and make an accurate throw across the diamond.
Now it's going to be Stephen Kwan. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one.
And you got to give some credit to the other side as well. They've been able to get out of a few tough jams, but frustration is mounting for this offense, no doubt.
0-1 down. Comes up empty. That's strike two. Off the mark there. Now 1-2.
Two strikes.
and a pitch. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. The Y to kick the pitch. Stays alive. The 1-2. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. The 1-2. Off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Well, he's been working out of the stretch just about the entire game, Boog. A lot of base runners on against him, and he's just done a really nice job of scattering the hits, not giving up any runs. But at some point, your luck usually runs out.
Now it's Jose Ramirez. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. And there's a strike. Jose Ramirez had a sensational 2018 season. He became just the eighth player ever to have a season with 30 doubles, 30 homers, 30 steals, and walking more than he struck out. Next one is off the plate. Now two balls and a strike. Clevinger with a pickoff throw, and he's back in easily. And a 2-1 on the way. That misses off the outside edge. And ball four to a board.
Oh, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taken ball four.
Mike Zunino digs in for the Guardians. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one.
Here's an opportunity. If you're going to get back in this game, you have to take advantage of this situation. This feels like their chance.
Next offering is in for a strike. Movement for the White Sox in their bullpen. Jimmy Lambert, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Santos warming up as well. Runners at first and second with one gone. Him looking, that's a strikeout.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
Here's Josh Naylor. That one misses, and that is ball one. First and second, two down. Next pitch way upstairs. Line drive, base hit. Kwan around third. One run is in. They're waving Ramirez home. The relay to the plate, and he's out. But one run does score on the play before the inning ends. A run on two hits and they leave one. Last half of the fifth coming up. It's the White Sox 5 and the Guardians 1. Back here on the south side, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Tim Anderson. First offering misses the mark.
You know, these White Sox, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. They've been lining the ball all over the ballpark, and unfortunately, sometimes it's right into a glove. But still, they've hit 9 line drives so far, and that's something they should feel very good about.
The 1-1. And that one is in for a strike.
Speaking of those line drives, you can't get too discouraged when they don't drop in for you. It's important to remember that you pretty much did everything right, and that's just baseball sometimes.
Ripped on a line to center. Straw right there to make the grab. And there's one down.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time up, he'll find a hole.
And now it's Luis Robert. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Pitch misses, and now it's even 1-1. Fought off foul. And it's even up.
2-2 down.
And now it's filled up.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Kicks and deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate. The game plan that he's sticking to is just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
Manager out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Logan Allen will depart, and we'll be back with their first arm out of the pen after a quick break. So Cleveland brings on a new reliever, Xavion Curry.
Number 44, Xavion Curry.
Man at first with one gone. Andrew Benintendi steps up. Singled and scored back in the first. He's 1-for-2.
Here we go, Andrew.
When you look at Benintendi, think about this. He played in the same conference as both Alex Bregman and Dansby Swanson. Those two guys picked ahead of him in the first round. But it was Benintendi who was the SEC Player of the year they all got drafted. There's one. On to first, double play. And that's the inning. Offense held in check there. 5 innings complete. It's the White Sox 5 and the Guardians 1. They hand the ball over to a new arm, Jimmy Lambert.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
So in now for Cleveland, Oscar Gonzalez.
Really nice swing in his last at bat. Shot a line drive into center field.
Now, when you think about players in the past or even in today's game, who's a comparison?
He reminds me a little bit of Harold Baines. Both of them lefties, both outfielders, and he's shown similar types of production at the plate.
Next offering misses, and the count even 1-1. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Right-handed reliever. Bounced up the middle. A dive. He's got it to first. It's there, and that's a great play.
Well, you can see right there, he looks very comfortable going to the backhand. Nice diving stop. Gets up to complete the play. That'll fire the boys up for sure.
Josh Bell at the plate now. Out to short, Anderson gathers and throws to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
The batter, number one, shortstop, Ahmed.
Ahmed Rosario digs in for the Guardians. Rosario in his sixth season, 27 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. And first offering is fouled off.
Where do you even begin with the talent we've seen from the Dominican Republic? Vladdy, Big Poppy, Pedro, the list goes on and on.
Swing, and that ball smashed on a line and a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Runner at first with two away. Miles Straw digs in now. In there, and it's 0-1. You'll one.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. Ball outside. Tag. Save. Grandal's throw not in time. Chris's wheels were the difference maker on that play. Just got in there.
Yeah, with StatCast's help, we see his top speed on this stolen base, and that's a big number. I mean, man, he really made his athleticism work for him on that one.
The 1-2. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Man on second, two down. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Runner at second, two down. Swing and a miss, and he got him. Out number three. One left for the Guardians. They're down here, 5-1. Bottom of the six, and now the DH, Eloy Jimenez. Curry, in his rookie season, 24 years old, and he was drafted in the seventh round back in 2019. Action in the pen down there. Aniel De Los Santos up and throwing for Terry Francona. The pitch. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Now he'll turn for second. Not in time. He's got a double.
Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
So a man aboard. And now Yoan Moncada. 1-2. That one's in there, 0-1. No outs, runner on second. Let's put a few on the board. 0-2 as he waves at that one.
Quickly in an 0-2 count, you've got to figure out a way to shorten your path to the baseball. Put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
Just blown away in that at bat. Three fastballs, all strikes. He wasn't even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take away from an at bat like that as a hitter other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. Got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
Vaughn stands in now and watches strike one. There's a strike. Next offering is downstairs. Runner at second here, one gone. And down on strikes, two away.
Now batting, catcher, Yasmani.
And now up to the plate, Yasmani Grandal. That misses the zone, and it's 1-0. And delivers outside. And 2-0 is in for a strike. There's a strike.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
Runner leads away at second. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. The pitch. And now the count filled up 3-2. And the pitch. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Very close off the outside corner. Could have easily been called a strike in that location.
Right fielder, Oscar.
Number 79 stands in with two away as he takes a ball. The next offering misses. 2-0.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
Righty delivers.
Ball three.
Elvis Andrus would be next if they can extend the inning.
And he's homered already, so I'm sure he'd love a chance to do some more damage here.
Left-hand batter waits. And that's ball four.
That's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Here's the second baseman, Elvis Andrus. And he's already left his mark on this game.
He certainly has, Boog. A two-run shot in the second inning, and that made an early impact on this game in a big way.
There's a strike.
Tough situation right here. So important as a pitcher to get ahead in the count as he did right there.
Two outs. Bases are full. To the left side, but it is well fouled.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
The 0-2. Fouls it back with two strikes. Next pitch inside. 1-2 to count. And he deals. Gets a piece and stays alive. One, two now. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. One and two here. And a ball evens the count.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there, like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
At the belt and fires. Battling here as he fouls it away. Grinding AB right here, about to see pitch number 10. And that one is lifted in the air. Makes the grab. That is the inning. And the White Sox will strand three. They lead this one, though, 5-1. Here at the ballpark, now it's the second baseman, Andrés Giménez. The Guardians in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
The pitch. And that's down and away.
Ball one, no strike.
And that's outside. Righty to the plate. On the inside corner for a strike.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
And that one missing low. Swing and a miss. And the count's full.
That's a really big swing right there. He's got to remember, with this speed, a walk or a single can turn into extra bases by stealing a base or two.
And here it comes. In the air, right side. Number 79, moving back for this one. Snags it on the run. One up, one down. Stephen Kwan, now at the plate. The MO for him is contact, a guy who's going to deliver average, not a ton of power. He's looking to hit a line drive somewhere.
Y'all, that's why it's a team. And when you look at a lineup, he's a great two-hole hitter or a guy that you could put at the bottom to help turn that lineup over to have some momentum for your top hitters coming up to the plate.
The 1-0. He was late there. Strike one.
Ooh, Baya. You got to remember to take the donut off the bat, partner.
Kicks and fires. Just off the inside edge. To third. Moncada tossed to first. And two away to start the seventh.
Third base, Jose Ramirez.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's the third baseman, Jose Ramirez. Flips the corner. That's strike one. Swings through that.
0-2 is the count.
Two outs. Into center. Robert moves under it. Makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. They're down 5-1. Set for the last half of the seventh. Stepping in, the White Sox leadoff man, Tim Anderson. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. That catches the corner. And that's in for a strike. That one inside, and that's ball one. And that's downstairs and outside. Right-hander kicks, deals. Lined, and that's a base hit. Around first, heading for two. And he's there with a leadoff double.
He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
And up next for Chicago, Luis Robert. And the first offering is not close.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
And the 1-0. There's a strike. Man at second. High in the air, out to right. Gonzalez moves under this one. He's there. He's got it. And there's one down.
The left fielder, number 23, Andrew Benintendi.
Now it's Andrew Benintendi to hit. One for three. That one ripped. That's back. Gone. He powers one out to right field, and they add a couple more. It's 7-1.
'90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Base is empty, one away. Eloy Jimenez now. That's in for a strike. Still only one out here in the inning. Next one misses, and it's a ball and a strike. There's a strike. Ah. in the air, left side. Kwan settles underneath it. And it's caught for the out.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Moncada at the plate with two away, swings through that one. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. The pitch. Got him looking. And that is that. But the White Sox with a two-run homer. And the lead is stretched to 7-1. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the catcher, Mike Zunino.
Mike Zunino.
Lambert back to work. And that's in for a strike. Foul ball there. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And one out now.
That's that classic wipeout slider below the zone right there. Just nasty. Looks like a fastball thigh high that you got to protect the zone. And then it's just that late break that fools you and kind of makes you look silly.
Naylor batting with one down, takes a strike.
0-1.
A little bit low. Next offering is down low.
I can't play around with him here. It's a 6-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
And a foul ball. Next pitch misses, and it's 3-2. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit.
All over that one right there. Now, fastball pretty much middle, and that's what you fall asleep dreaming about as a hitter. So no surprise, he put a great swing on it.
Runner on at first with one gone. Oscar Gonzalez getting ready to hit. It's off his shoulder, eats him up. Lead runner makes the turn at second. Benintendi to third. He's in there. One away, runners at first and third. Next is the DH, a switch hitter, Josh Bell. First and third, one down. Swings and crushes one. Right field, way back and gone. He'll touch them all. And they tack on three. It's 7-4.
One got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
Joe Kelly gets handed the rock out of the pen,
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
And up next for Cleveland, Ahmed Rosario.
He was the big part of the field last time. Nice liner to center.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
Next pitch misses inside, and it's 2-0. Movement in the bullpen, Kendall Graveman, the right-handed sinker baller. He looks to be readying himself. And that's through there for a strike. And the righty deals.
Ball three.
Ripped on a line, and it's into the gap. Around first and hustling for second. In safely, it's a double, and his second hit.
Four hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. Off the bat, it was headed for the gap all the way, and as a hitter, you love seeing those as you take your first couple of steps out of the box. You know you've got some real estate to run on. It's such a good feeling. Nice liner into the gap right there.
One out, runner at second. Stepping up for the Guardians, Miles Straw. Ball one there. Oh, he hit him. And that got him pretty flush.
I don't care what some players might say. Nobody likes getting hit by a pitch unless you're in an 0-2 count and there's a knuckleballer out there on the mound.
And first offering is fouled off.
Always tough to turn two on a speedster like this. It's even harder with him coming out of the left-handed batter's box. You really need something to hit hard on the ground that they can handle to turn two quickly.
Ripped to third. Tags the runner for one. On to Vaughn. Two. His homer brings the Guardians a bit closer. It's now a 7-4 ball game. A new arm into the game, the righty, Eli Morgan.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
So digging in, Andrew Vaughn.
For the White Sox, the first baseman, Andrew Vaughn.
Here comes a pitch. Top of the zone for a called strike. Good eye in that spot. That one missing inside. Out to center. Straw has a beat on it. Puts it away for the out.
Now batting the catcher.
Yasmani Grandal steps to the plate for the White Sox. And that's in there for strike one. Cleveland has some action going in their pen. Angel De Los Santos up and throwing for Terry Francona. The 0-1. And that one wrapped foul. Here's the 0-2. And ball one. Struck him out swinging. Chased the fastball up the ladder for strike three. Two outs, base is empty. Number 79 steps to the plate for the White Sox. Pitch misses inside. 1-0. Just missed. The wind and the pitch.
That's ball three. I got 3-0.
And there's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Andrews at the plate and takes high there.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
And there's a strike on the outside corner. Squirts away from Zunino. And a pitch. And now it's filled up. And ball four, two aboard.
So close to getting out of it right there. But this inning still has life.
Shortstop.
Tim Anderson steps to the plate for the White Sox.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field. Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
Next offering misses, ball one. And the slider catches the zone. The 1-2. That one lifted to left. Kwan heads after it and makes the grab. And the inning is over. White Sox strand a couple. They hold a 7-4 lead. Kendall Graveman on the pitch here.
I think closer has to be one of the toughest jobs in baseball, and we see a pretty high turnover rate because of it. Every outing seems to be high pressure, this one included. We'll see if he can wrap up the win and get himself a save.
Leading so digging in, Stephen Kwan.
The left fielder, Stephen
Graveman, Kwan. In his eighth season, 32 years old, and he was drafted in the eighth round back in 2013. And that's outside. And a pitch.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Check swing, and he held up. And the right-hander deals. That one fouled off. And now 2-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Next one is off the plate, and the count's full. Good job to fight that one off.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Left field. That gets down for a hit. Throws to second. Safe at second with a double. Third hit for him this afternoon.
The third baseman.
Just a blue pit behind third right there. And that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to. And the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there.
So man aboard. And now Jose Ramirez. Center field. Robert makes the play. Runner tagging for third. And he makes it up to third with one away.
Was able to move the runner up to third on that deep fly to center, but I think at this point he wants to get him over and get him in.
Stepping in, Mike Zunino.
Struck out on just three pitches last time. And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
In for a strike, 0-1. One away with a runner at third. And 1-2. Pitch fights it off. You'll see another. This ball's chopped on the ground. Andrews tosses to first. Now two away as they get a run across. And now it's Josh Naylor. Pitches in for a strike, and that's strike one.
One's the count.
Right-handed reliever, and a foul ball. Just one strike away.
Ball one.
And now one and two. And there's a ball.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
The pitch. Ground ball right side. On to first. Ball game.
Well, not all saves come easy, but he didn't let things unravel. Good win for the boys today.
A 7-5 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
First for the victorious White Sox, seven runs, seven hits, no errors. They left seven and on.